The Song of Songs, which is Shalamoa's. Let him touch me with the kisses of his mouth, for your affections are better than wine. Because of the savor of your good ointments, your name is as ointment poured forth. Therefore do the damsels love you. Draw me, we will run after you. The king has brought me into his chambers. We will be glad and rejoice in you. We shall commemorate your affections more than wine. The Yasharim love you. I am black and comely, O ye daughters of Jerusalem, as the tents of Kedar, as the shoots of Shalamoa. It must not be you staring at me because I am black, because I am tanned from the sun. My mother's sons were angry with me. They made me the keeper of the vineyards which were not my own. Tell you, O soul of mine, whom she loves, where you feed, where are you reclining at noon? Why should I become as one being muffled by the droves of your partners? If you know not, the lovely one among women, go your way by the footsteps of the flock and graze your kids beside the shepherd's tents. I have compared you, O my love, to a company of horses for Pharaoh's chariots. Your cheeks are comely with rows of jewels, your neck with chains, threaded gems. We will make you bead row of gold with specks of silver. Still the king's divine sends forth the scent of him for the spikenard he gave me. A pouch of myrrh is my darling to me. He is lodging between my breast. My darling is to me a cluster of the henna blossom in the vineyards of Engedi. Behold you, lovely shepherdess, behold you. You have the lovely eyes of doves. Behold you, my darling, you are pleasant indeed. Also our couch is flourishing. The beams of our court are cedar, and our rafters and panels are fir. I am the rose of Sharon and the lily of the valleys. As the lily among the thistles, so is the shepherdess of mine among the daughters. As the apricot tree is among the trees of the wildwood, so is my darling among the sons. In his shadow I covet and I sit, and his fruit is sweet to my palate. He brings me to the house of wine, and his banner over me is love. Steady me with raisin cakes, comfort me with apricots that are ailing of love. His left arm is under my head, and his right arm embraces me. I charge you, daughters of Jerusalem, by the gazelles and by the hinds of the field, if you rouse the love before she desires. The voice of my darling, behold, he comes leaping over the mountains, running over the hills. My darling is like a gazelle or a fawn of the deer. Behold, he stands behind our wall, peering from the windows, gazing through the lattices. My darling answered and said to me, arise, my shepherdess, my lovely one, and come away. Behold, the winter weather is past, the downpour is past, the flowers are seen in the land, the time of pruning has attained, and the sound of the turtle dove is heard in our land. The fig tree puts forth her green figs, and the vines with the tender grape give scent. Arise, my lovely shepherdess, and come away. My dove, let me see you in the encircling of the crag, in the concealment of the cliff, and the appearance of you. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet, and it makes your appearance even more comely. Hold for us the foxes, the little foxes, that harm the vineyards and our vineyards of vine blossoms. Him, the one grazing among the lilies, still the day blows in, and the shadows flee away. Yet you, my darling, will be like a gazelle, or the fawn of a deer on many mountains. On my bed in the nights, I sought him, whom my soul loves. I sought him, but I did not find him. I will rise now and go around the city in the streets, and in the squares I will seek him, whom my soul loves. I sought him, but I did not find him. The men guarding the city found me, to whom I said, have you seen whom my soul loves? It was but a little time that I passed from them, that I found him whom my soul loves. I held him and would not let him go, until I had brought him into my mother's house and into the chamber of her that conceived me. I charge you, daughters of Jerusalem, by the gazelles and by the hinds of the field, if you rouse the love before she desires, who is ascending from the wilderness like pillars of smoke, perfumed with myrrh and frankincense, from all of the powders of the merchant. Behold the couch of Shalomaz, 60 masterful men are round it, the masterful men of Yashrael. They all hold swords, being experts in war, every man having his sword upon his thigh in case of alarm in the night. King Shalomaz made himself a cedar litter of the wood of Lebanon. He made the columns of silver, the chair of gold, the writing seat of it of purple, the midst thereof being paved with love from the daughters of Jerusalem. Come forth, you, O ye daughters of Zion, and see King Shalomaz in the crown which his mother crowned him in the day of his espousal, and in the day of the rejoicing of his heart. Behold, you lovely shepherdess, behold, you are fair. You have the lovely eyes of doves which are seen through your face veil. Your hair glistens like a flock of goats as they glisten from Mount Gilead. Your teeth are like a drove of those being fashioned from the washing, all of which have twins and none of which are bereaved. Your lips are like a thread of double-dipped scarlet, and your speech is comely. Your temples are like a piece of a pomegranate that can be seen through your veil. Your neck is like the Tower of David, built for an armory, thousands of buckles and the shields of the masterful men. Your two breasts are like two fawns, the twins of a gazelle, which graze among the lilies. Until the day blows in and the shadows flee away, I shall go to the mountain of myrrh and to the hill of frankincense. All of you is a lovely shepherdess, and there is no blemish in you. Come with me from Lebanon, my bride. From Lebanon you shall come. You shall see from the top of Amana, from the top of Shinar and Sherman, from the lion's dens, from the mountains of the leopards. You stir my heart, my sister, my bride. You stir my heart with one of your eyes, with one necklace on your neck. Your affections are lovely, my sister, my bride. How much better is your affections than wine, and the smell of your ointments than all spices. Your lips, my bride, drip with honey. Honey and milk are under your tongue, and the scent of your garment is like the scent of Lebanon. Garden is latched, my sister, my bride. The surrounding pool is latched. The spring is sealed. Your plants are an orchard of pomegranates with pleasant fruits, henna blossoms with spikenard and saffron reed and cinnamon, with all woods of frankincense, myrrh and aloes, with all tops of aromatics, a spring of gardens, a well of living waters, and streams flowing from Lebanon. Awake, O north wind, and come. You south wind, blow upon my garden, that the aromatics may flow out. My darling shall come into his garden, and he shall eat his fine fruits. I am come into my garden, my sister, my bride. I nip off my myrrh with my spice. I eat wild wood fair with honey. I drink my wine with my milk. Eat, my friends, and drink, and get drunk, my friends. I am sleeping, but my heart is aroused with the sound of my darling knocking. Open to me, my sister, my shepherdess, my dove, my flawless one, for my head is filled with night mist, and my locks with the moistures of the night. I have put off my tunic. How shall I put it on? I have washed my feet. How shall I make them dirty? My darling put forth his hand from the hole, and my heart was moved for him. I rose up to open to my darling, and my hands dropped with myrrh, and my fingers with sweet-smelling myrrh upon the handles of the latch. I opened for my darling, but my darling eluded me and had passed by my soul. I went forth to speak of him. I called him, but he gave me no answer. They found for me the men guarding and going around the city. They smote me, they injured me. The ones guarding the walls lifted garment of mine. I charge you, O daughters of Jerusalem, if ye find my darling, tell him that I am ailing of love. Who is your darling from another darling, lovely woman? Who is your darling more than another darling that you so charge us? My beloved is elegant and ruddy and outstanding among 10,000s. His head is glittering gold. His locks are pendulous and black as a raven. His eyes are as the eyes of doves by the rivers of waters, washed with milk and fully set. His cheeks are as a tower of spices, as sweet flowers, his lips like lilies, dropping sweet-smelling myrrh. His hands are as rolls of gold filled with topaz. His belly is as bright ivory overlaid with sapphires. His legs are as columns of marble set upon sockets of fine gold. His appearance is as Lebanon, choice as the cedars. The taste of him is sweetness. This darling of mine, this shepherd of mine, is coveted by the daughters of Jerusalem.